Hello, world. My name is Chile DeCastro. I'm a journalist who's been wrongfully imprisoned at the Clark County Detention Center in Las Vegas, Nevada. I am an innocent man who has been jailed unjustly and unrighteously. I'm a journalist. I have a voice. I have a voice that should be heard. My videos on YouTube alone are heard or watched a million times a day. This report is my verbal op-ed. Judge Ann Zimmerman, this message is to you. Release me from this jail, please. I've taken responsibility publicly and agreed with my family, friends, and colleagues that my behavior in court was inappropriate. I fully believe, teach, and lecture about the rule of law being fundamental to our society. It is for this reason I say to Judge Ann Zimmerman now, release me from this jail, please. The nature of government and the principle of government are different. The nature of law is how it is consisted, the structure of it, of objective law. The principle of law is how government acts, how it behaves. It is the human passion that sets government into motion. This understanding of nature versus principle comes directly from Montesquieu's book, The Spirit of Lawz. Well then, Judge Ann Zimmerman's principles are inconsistent and out of bounds. Why and how can I state this so emphatically clear? We have scraped the data and analyzed the last 2,000 cases of Judge Ann Zimmerman. We have identified a dozen cases that went back to a bench trial. A bench trial means that Judge Zimmerman is the judge, jury, and executioner. And so far, we have three exact cases that are the same as my charges, the same NRS codes. In the past year, this judge has given these three defendants impulse training classes, and then the misdemeanor would fall off their record. The data will show her consistency and that she broke her principles, putting me in jail. Judge Ann Zimmerman, release me from this jail at once, please. Why would the judge show obvious bias and give me such an unfair and harsh sentence? What can you do about it? First, because Zimmerman is not her maiden name. Zimmerman is the name of the Las Vegas Metro Police Lieutenant she married over two decades ago. Even after he divorced her, she kept the last name, meaning Judge Zimmerman loves cops and I do not. She formed her bias and hatred for me before the sham trial even began. Second, what can you do about it? You can petition her and petition the court to release me now. I know for a fact that thousands of you, good and patriotic Americans, have called, emailed, and sent your petition to the court in the form of a letter, asking and demanding that I am released from this dungeon. Thank you, but we have not done enough. We, you and me, have a First Amendment right to petition our government and its officials when they have lost their virtue and broken their principles. We have not petitioned them enough. It is our only recourse to redress the clear and biased judge who's gone out of her reason and purpose to jail a nonviolent journalist. Zimmerman has behaved like a monarch or a queen in a despotic government, like a rogue judge in an aristocratic government. We have a republic government that is supposed to be navigated by objective law, not by personal bias, by a judge who was the wife of a cop. Instead of acting as a custodian of justice, she has behaved like an obvious tyrant. Petition her. Petition her and demand that she release me from this dungeon immediately, swiftly, and please. Petition the court in the tens of thousands because it is the only recourse that we, the people, have. Judge Zimmerman, the only way you will be able to restore the word honor to your name is by releasing me now. I have owned my errors, Judge, but have you owned yours? I don't think that you followed the rule of law on that day in court. You've lost integrity. I do not believe that you have the right to search me illegally. I believe that you violated my constitutional rights, as did the bailiff under your directive when he snatched the phones out of my hand. The bar complaint I'll be filing, well, it may eventually determine that. It depends. However, my two petitions will most certainly be filed. I had six full-time employees and now only three. Because the biased Judge Zimmerman did not give me 3 days to get my business orders and affairs in order, she simply threw me in jail, directly from court. Perhaps it is because you, Judge Zimmerman, needs impulse training classes. This is not an apology. I said I'm sorry for hurling slurs in court and calling the bailiff a pig, even if he was behaving like one. The courtroom is supposed to be a place where the insults cease, and using objective, defined law, an impartial judge and jury, using rationale, integrity, reason, attempt to find and administer justice. I have received none of that. Instead, my rights were violated from the start. Petition her and petition this court. Send in your petition via U.S. Postal Service. Do not be rude, crass, or threatening. Hold on to your virtue and your self-respect, and Judge Zimmerman lost when she put a nonviolent journalist, a champion of our civil liberties, in jail. Do not call names, no. Go above and beyond. Be immaculate with your verbiage. Be the change you want to see on the paper you write upon. I do not wish Judge Zimmerman fear or harm. No, I do not. I want her to live every breath of her life where she sees the public has turned against her. I want her to witness the side-eye sneer in every grocery store clerk, in every market, in every chance encounter, whether it be the dog groomer or the car wash. She will be the face of injustice, the living embodiment of tyranny. Judge Zimmerman, at sentencing, said to me that I hate cops. I thought it was my right to hate cops if I want to. If this is true or not, she said it and then jailed me. Why would I despise the cop? Because thinking is man's only basic virtue. To live, a man must hold three things supreme: reason, purpose, and self-esteem. We no longer need to chain people's wrists behind their backs with the use of cameras and tracking devices available today. Technology can now end the chaining of people, incapacitating human beings with chains around their wrists behind their backs. Now, today, this could happen immediately. These men and women have been bought to turn off their brain, to repeat inhumane rhetoric like they're not supposed to be comfortable, as they put torture cuffs on people, as they are paid too much money. The money they earn should only be based on their knowledge and their ability. If these people can't see that they are greedy little pigs, then test the job market. Put your resume out. You are not a $100,000 a year man. Put your resume out on the job market and find out what you get. The job market will show you your true value. Knowledge plus ability equals product or value of your labor. Your so-called knowledge is the policy given to you, and you have the ability to turn off your brain and morality to chain and cage humans. And that's why you're giving health, vision, and dental plans, not because you have virtuously created your value. You, the cop, who I have called a pig, are willing to chain and cage humans. It's so sick and twisted. It's so immoral and wrong. But you do it for you and yourself alone. All of man's endeavors are primarily for self, and we know this is true. Judge Zimmerman jailed me for herself, to justify hating me for what I do. Point out the injustice and despotic government, for her to justify her love of the cop. How many cops does Judge Zimmerman work with week in and week out? How many cops from her wedding over two decades ago is she still in a chummy relationship with decades later? Judge Zimmerman, how many hours of my videos did you watch before you met me in court? How many hours of my videos have you watched since court ended? At my appeal bond hearing, Judge Zimmerman said that my attitude has not changed. What does my attitude have to do with objective law? You think that jailing me will force me to endorse a system of torture cuffs and despotism? I am chained by my wrists and ankles when I'm taken to court. You think my attitude is the problem? Open your eyes. Change her from the slave era. We are now in a digital era. Why don't we move the bailiff station between the judge and the defendant? Oh, wow. Yeah, change the layout. Think about how easy it would be. Instead of torture cuffing people, put a V-neck frame over their shoulders, much like football pads, with a camera on the front of the chest and a camera on the back of the chest. Can you imagine that? Actually not putting people in torture cuffs and adding a tracking device? Chaining anybody except the criminally insane is inhumane and barbaric. Technology will eventually change everything, but not with these despotic people in our government. I say now, petition her. Petition the court. Release me now. 100,000 petitions. Send in your patriotic, respectful, detailed petition to Judge Ann Zimmerman. On the fold where you seal the envelope, write the words, "Release DeCastro in the name of justice." 100,000 petitions is our goal. Judge Zimmerman, the only way to restore any honor to your name is to release me now with time served. It's a fact that I will sue you. If you do not have me killed in here, then when I leave this jail, I will in fact sue you. I do not deserve to be here. Judge Zimmerman was wrong. She showed her bias and violated my civil rights. I will take every legal step possible to rectify this injustice. However, I will not do anything illegal, and I'm not asking you in any way, shape, or form to step out of bounds. What we will not do is give them what they want. They want to brand us bad. They want to brand us outcast, fringe, and lawless. Be beyond reproach in your petition. Write nicely and print it out. Explain clear this cop-loving judge bias and her indefensible sentencing Her own cases show the data that she does not put people in jail for this, and she did it to me because of her bias. We'll post both in the Las Vegas Review and the Sun when all the data scraping is completed and her cases are compiled. She broke her principles and she lost her virtue. Write it out, write it nicely, write it clear, write it clean. Just write it, put it in the mail, and send it. I have been warned by the Las Vegas police that this jail can take away my phone privileges and make my time here very hard. To my jailers, I say to you this. I've been quiet, respectful, and shown deference to all jail staff. My calling for this tyrannical judge to be petitioned is my right, and it is our right. It is your rights I am standing on now. I do not agree with locking me in a cell for 23 hours a day. I do not consider what you did to me fair or justice. Upon leaving this jail, should I live through this, I will file a petition against the Clark County Detention Center for clearly cheating me and violating my civil rights. Nowhere in the Clark County Detention Center handbook does it read the words, no live streaming. Once again, technology has passed up the dated government policy. However, I ask this question to my jailers. Do you want to live in a country with no free speech, no right to petition, assemble, religion, or to be the press? It is for the rule of law that I stand here today before you. It is my right to call for petition, non-violently protest, to non-violently assemble. To my loyal people and supporters, you should hear from me always within 48 hours. Always. Please, unless you do not hear from me, let the jailers be. Outside of the unlawful imprisonment, when they locked me down for 5 days, strip-searched me, and demoralized me by looking at my backside, outside of that, each individual guard has treated me fairly and within their policies. I would like to thank them for doing that. I'd like my people to focus on petitioning the court for my release. We have another judge, Judge Michelle Levitt, who will be hearing my case on July 10th. The judges must be treated with respect and deference. The judges must be petitioned and told that this is wrong. I should be released immediately with time served. We will fight the appeal process all the way to the U.S. Supreme Court if we must. We don't stop. Judge Zimmerman, I'm keeping my word and speaking and behaving with deference to the court. Own your error. This is injustice. Release me now, please. And thank you. Thank you all. This is Chile DeCastro, and this is my daily report. Catch you guys on the next one. Later, Gators.